without studying music? How can one understand any society without understanding what people sing, what they listen for pleasure? What they listen for pleasure. How can one understand anxieties, the zeitgeist of a society, if one does not know music or song? What if we're talking about a communist society, or totalitarian society, whatever that means? We know that music was such a core, important part of the communist society that no aspect of everyday life went without it. Music mobilized people to build communist future. Music mobilized people to fight wars. Music also entertained them when they didn't know, when they didn't want to fight those wars, or sometimes it entertained, it helped them to release their emotions and provided outlet for their sense of humor. Music was also social commentary. So much of what we know in Jewish history comes to us from music. How people felt about draft in the Tsarist army in the 19th century, what people thought about pogroms. In fact, songs about pogroms come to us from the early 17th century, unfortunately. Songs create medium for preservation of historical memory and commemorating political and historical events. But what if this music is a music of a minority? What if it's music that documents shameful history, history that one wants to forget? So many questions, such difficult research, so few answers. David Shneer and I, who escaped his microphone, David Shneer and I are working on two different countries, two different languages, well, kind of one the same language and two others different. Two different historical contexts. But we both came to the conclusion that in order to study art, in order to study those societies, in order to answer those research questions, we have to either invite artists to help us or to become artists ourselves. There is no way around. So this is what we came up with. Thank you so much for coming. And I pass the torch to David Shneer and Jewlia Eisenberg.